Our values as a nation, I think, are the key to keeping us actually safe from the weak, woke world. Australia and most Australians actually does stand for stuff, but we're envied as much as we are admired. Look, I get it. There's lots of pleasant distraction. There's attractive alternatives to our principles and our values, and the sweet treats of the weak and the woke, like anything sweet, provides a rush. Now, the powerful, intoxicating, addictive affection of the weak and the woke and the world, the rich and the famous with their lavish lifestyles, their trappings of wealth, now, they must be right every time they virtue signal about, well, anything. These godlike types, they taunt, they demand our adherence to their new religions of climate change, of the Great Reset, of building back better. You know, you hear all the slogans. All of these things are ways to psych us, to sucker us into abandoning our principles and our values. And these weak and woke disciples really are evil. That's right, they're evil. They label those of us who stand in defence of our principles and values, of trusting people in our society, of believing in personal freedom and personal responsibility as causes worthy of effort, they say that we're lacking a progressive sense of change. Well, in the past few weeks, we've actually seen principles operating within the Australian government, even though several of the states are still stuck in waging an unprincipled war against their citizens. These restrictions on freedom, dressed up as keeping us safe, well, that's the same mantra that was used 90 years ago by the National Socialists in Germany. Keeping the populist alarmed rather than alert shows a real distrust, and that's the sort of distrust always used by tyrants throughout history. The Australian government, though, has reinvigorated our principles and values, in my view. On the national sovereignty front, the expansion of our relationships with like-minded democratic nations like the UK, the US, India and Japan shows Australia is strutting principles and values. And now in recent days, former Prime Minister Tony Abbott has been in Taipei, the capital of Taiwan, the Free Republic of China. You know, having a former Prime Minister meet an elected Taiwanese president, Madam Tsai Ing-wen, is absolutely significant. I mean, first off, he's been allowed to travel out of Australia. So it shows a deliberate sanctioned signal that Australia is standing with Taiwan as the undemocratic China across the Taiwan Straits, the aggressive communists, are taunting Taiwan. Mr. Abbott said it was his first ever visit to Taiwan, but it won't be his last. That was a principal pitch. And in a few weeks, the current Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, is meant to meet the weak and the woke world at the latest climate change love-in, this time being held in Glasgow, Scotland. A viewer of this program, Martin, sent me a note of concern this week, suggesting the weak and the woke are actually lying in wait to bully ScoMo. Martin says, it struck me, all these Western leaders being stuck in chilly Glasgow in the middle of an energy crisis was a very bad strategic decision, while China is being so aggressive towards Taiwan. Just imagine how difficult it could become if they chose to invade as the COP, the global warming meeting, was actually in session. You know, Martin's worried that Boris and Biden are amongst the bullies. Of course they are. Of course they are. You see, this climate change con is the weapon. Australia is the target for the weak and the woke leaders of the world. They're really just doing what China wants them to do. Big distractions. And with the weak and the woke demanding adherence to their plan for our nation, in many ways, there's no need to go to Glasgow. The weak and the woke will just keep attacking us no matter what we do, no matter how principled we are. And the weak and the woke world has decided a weaker Australia is better for their cause. So let's hope the Prime Minister continues to act by what suits Australian interests, because we are better than most and we must remain strong and prove how our values underpin our strength. Keen to know what you think. Hashtag Hardgrave if you want to send me a tweet. You can also write me directly, gary.hardgrave@skynews.com.au.